I want to share some links to some videos that I found for making masks. So it is recommended that people wear masks. I think one of the benefits to wearing a mask is that it's a constant reminder to not touch one's face. And I think a lot of times people touch their face without realizing that they've done so. And I think that having a mask on is a constant reminder to not touch one's face. I'm going to link a video that I used to make masks. I'm making masks for friends and family. They're washable and they have a pocket to insert filters. It's different things for filters. I think like coffee filters. There are filters for tea where you can put loose tea into filters. There are all sorts of different things that can be used for filters. I don't know how effective each filter is, but it is an additional layer and like an additional barrier. So within the mask, and they're, you know, they can be removed and replaced, and they're not expensive, and they also tend to come in large quantities. Of course, the best thing to do is shelter at home, you know, and just have what you need delivered. But for those that can't do that, masks are good. Where I live, actually starting tomorrow, actually at midnight, all workers, like everyone that goes to work, is required to wear a mask. So, and then the public is strongly encouraged when they are out. Of course, if they need to be out in public, because if they don't need to be out in public, they shouldn't go out in public. Those that go out are also, they are encouraged to wear masks. Here, it's becoming a mandate for workers, essential workers, to wear masks. So there's a sewing one, and it's pretty simple. And then there is one that is a no-sew one. So I haven't tried the no-sew folding, like you kind of fold the scarf, and you can also place filters into that one, I think. You can probably use some safety pins or kind of keep it in place if that's an issue. And also there is glue. There's fabric glue that can be used instead of sewing. You can use sewing glue, and it's really good, actually. Sewing, and you can wash the material over and over, and the sewing glue stays in place. So that's a really neat thing. And of course, filter options. You know, some people use tissues, coffee filters, little bags like tea filters. There are all sorts of different things that people use just to add additional layers of protection. And then, of course, for me, I think it's really important is that it's a reminder to not touch your face. I've been sewing today and gardening, and we had an earthquake actually about 2 hours ago, it was a 4.9, and it was felt as far north as Los Angeles, as far south as into Mexico, obviously to the ocean, and then into Riverside, I believe. So the whole area shook. I did feel it. I hope no one is hurt. I've been in many earthquakes. I was actually in a giant earthquake. This is a 4.9, so it's not too big, but it is a shake. And I've been in some longer earthquakes. I've been in earthquakes up at the San Andreas Fault in Northern California, in several growing up in Northern California. And I've been in a few out here. But it had been a couple of years where I missed, you know, where there were earthquakes, and I was just in a situation where I didn't feel it. You know, it'd been years, and now I felt an earthquake. So, and it was smooth. You know, you could feel the shake. It was a side to side one. It's from a fault line. Actually, that fault line is capable of producing, you know, 7-pointers. And then there's, of course, there's a 5% chance that it may lead to a larger earthquake. Like there could be this could have been a 4 shock to a larger earthquake, but there's only a 5% chance of that. But I mean, there's still a chance. So right as I was finishing editing, or where I was thinking about where I was finishing up editing the video, I felt an aftershock. A friend of mine texted me that there was an aftershock, and I checked the message right away. And when I saw that there was an aftershock, I was able to feel it. I was reading, was it yesterday or the day before, about how because of the quarantine, because of the decreased activity on the planet, that the Earth's crust is moving less. So it's just a change that, you know, I mean, I don't know what that means other than there's been a change, a measurable change of activity on the Earth's crust, because human movement, vehicles, and all these different things that we do on the Earth causes the Earth's crust to shape, to move. And so it's now moving less. So I don't know what that means, except for that there's decreased movement. We just had an earthquake. I just felt an aftershock. I know that there have been changes on the Earth's crust. So it's important. I just went over earthquake safety plan, where all the shutoff points are for water, electricity, gas, shoes in a safe, easy to access place, a flashlight, you know, just making sure that safety materials, things like candles and other things that would assist in the event that the power were to go out, if, in the event that anything else were to happen, that immediate safety measures can be taken, and that what a person needs to do those things is quickly and easily accessible. Another thing, and this is just something that's kind of a regular thing about being Californian, and that is just being aware of where items are placed, because in earthquakes, things fall. They fall, the earth is shaking, and it just things will fall. And so if you have heavy things that are up high, you know, it's something to, it's important to consider earthquakes when placing things in different places. I think it's important to kind of go through and just make sure that a person is in fact considering earthquakes in the areas where they sleep, and just pretty much anywhere, so that they are not injured by falling objects. You know, smaller earthquakes can feel quite interesting. Larger earthquakes are actually completely different. I mean, there's a different feeling. It is really a very serious thing. If you're in an earthquake-prone area, just make sure that you run through your safety plans, that you know what to do, and you know, just run over safety plans. There are a lot of them available online on, you know, what to do, you know, do's and don'ts. I hope everyone is safe, and I hope everyone has safety plans.